Yes, we are back with more of White in the Morning for you. I go by the name of Barry Moses, or It's Barry More on every social media platform. Special thanks to Hilda Wathithi and Sylvia for that informative interview about the beauty industry. So White54 channel on Twitter, White54 underscore channel on Instagram, and White54 on Facebook is the way to reach us. Don't forget the hashtag White in the Morning, and don't forget the hashtag Entrepreneurship Tuesday. So right about now, I have a very powerful gentleman in studio with me. He is a photographer, but is also mentoring kids through teaching them another language that is not taught in our education system. He goes by the name Henry Were, all the way from Kakamega County, represented on Wine in the Morning. Karibu sana.
Thank you very much.
Henry, if I missed anything, I like to give everybody a chance to introduce themselves and show off. Your camera is number four.
Thank you very much. My name is Henry Joe Were, passionate creative director at Sir Henry Films. It's my own brand. I'm also a photographer at Queen Studios Photography. That's where I currently work at the moment. I'm also a teacher by passion, not by
training or profession.
I haven't gone for training, but it's just by passion. I'm also a photographer.
Yeah, this is your main hustle, Henry. Yes. Right. Out of all these things that you do, did you have to go to school for any of them?
What I've studied actually is French until Form 4 level. That's the only level I've...
Alright.
Yeah, exactly.
Which school is this that you learned your French that gives you the confidence of standing in front of other kids and teaching them this language?
I'm a proud alumni of St. Peter's Mumias Boys High School. Thanks to Mr. Wekesa. He's the one who taught me French.
Shout out to Mr. Wekesa.
Yeah, Monsieur Wekesa.
Henry's teacher. And now you're impacting the world through this particular language.
Yeah, exactly.
But before we talk about how you're impacting the world and kids through teaching them French, I'd like to know, you grew up in Kakamega County.
Yes, Kakamega kwenyewe tu kwenye nyumbani.
I like how you said that. Yeah. All right, so how was it growing up in Kakamega County? And why did you choose to come and continue your hustle in Nairobi?
Kakamega, life is kind of tricky. So it was around in 2016 when I completed my Form 4 level, and I happened to be blessed to pursue my passion. Actually, since I was a kid, I always wanted to be a pilot. And I did well in high school, though I was very stubborn, very much stubborn.
Very stubborn. Mr. Nani anajua?
Mr. Wekesa anajua? Ata Mr. Namunga, Dennis, my deputy principal. I've been so stubborn, but I happened to Kazana. I did fairly well, and I was placed to pursue by diploma in flight operation and dispatch at East African School of Aviation. But unfortunately, the school that I was placed at doesn't ikubali help. So due to financial constraints at home, I had no chance to join the school. Niliboeka sana, because that's actually what I wanted since I was a kid. Nilikuwa naendesha. Apart from kuendesha kwa choo, nilikuwa pia naendesha together.
All right. So you like to make these toys, and you like to fly these toys.
Yeah.
It was always your passion. How did you feel like when you got locked from going into college and pursuing what you had dreamt for? Did you feel like your life had come to an end?
Yeah, kinda. I was too down. Bearing in mind my dad ndo alikuwa amemaliza job, ameretire. So there was no anywhere I could get funds.
Alright.
And I really wanted to continue with my studies and pursue my career as a pilot.
How? At what point did you say, did you get over your aggravations and said, all right, I can do something with my hands, let me pick up a camera?
Okay, I wasn't passionate about photography, but now that it was the only option I was having, I had to make it my passion to pursue it as a career so that I can get cash to take me to school. So I happened to have a small camera at home. It was a Sony Coolpix. So matanga zote, harambe zote nyumbani, I was updated. I used to go hustle. Natoka asubuhi, naenda napiga paparazi, Kuko Village. take photos of kids, 50 uh-huh. bob, 50 bob, uh-huh. neka, then I go uh-huh. wash them, na later too. But then I saw, it was kind of getting
pose hapo kwa washing them. Not so many kids understand when you say wash, because outside when I do a smartphone, I go print, smartphone print.
Yeah.
You were using a film camera.
Not really a film camera, uh-huh. it was a digital one.
A digital one.
It is in Zimbekuja. Then right. we have these now DSLR cameras.
All right.
The big ones. All right. The one I'm having currently. All
right.
Yeah.
So business was booming.
If our business was good.
Mm-hmm.
Kuingiza 300 in a day, it was good for me.
Uh-huh. But this is back in Kakamega?
Back in Kakamega kwenye nyumbani.
All right, all right.
Yeah. But uh-huh. I saw. I ningizi vizuri, so I had to look for other extra hustles
uh-huh.
so that I can get cash. Uh-huh. I get a bigger camera, po passion ikaanza kugrow, kugrow slowly, uh-huh. slowly. So I opted to start mujengo. I did the matofali mm-hmm. at home. Niliharibisha sana shamba.
Mm-hmm.
I used to dig, it was around half an hectare.
Mm-hmm.
So nilienda, nikatafuta maboizu wangu.
Mm-hmm.
So we had to dig, tukaunda mm-hmm. matofali. We used to sell,
mm-hmm.
It was around 5 shillings each. Mm-hmm. So tunachoma,
mm-hmm.
so you know that ritual as yeah. lawyers, uh-huh. lazima tuchome ndani kuku.
Alright. So while mnachoma the bricks,
yeah.
So the bricks are made from clay.
From clay, exactly.
Did you have to get the machine to press them first?
Why should we get from a machine and yet we can improvise?
Uh-huh. So yeah. you improvised, you can fix mambao zenu pale, you make the bricks and then you burn them.
Yeah.
Like in the process of burning, jumbe sweat sana kuku inaingia ndani.
Eka kuku kaingia ndani. Kachoko.
Kachoko kaingia ndani.
Exactly.
And then that is what you eat.
Yeah, that's
were
what
you participating
eat.
In farming as well?
Yeah, farming. I've been farming.
So you had chicken?
Chicken, yeah.
Mm, but ziko?
Ziko.
Mm, unatumiwa from time to time?
Yeah, time to time. Lazima nikienda huko. Kakuku hapa.
All right.
Yeah.
Already.
Na kagunia.
I like this so much because yes. You never gave up.
I never gave up.
You started hustling, but you had a vision. You yeah. wanted to go to the big city
yeah.
and do something.
Yeah.
So finally, you got a chance to come to the big city.
Yes.
Did you tell your parents, now I want to go to Nairobi and this is what I'm going to do? Did
yes.
you have to have that conversation with them?
Actually, I had to talk to mom and dad.
Mm-hmm.
I told them, mom,
mm-hmm.
I'm getting old, though Dev bado zinani betray,
mm-hmm.
but hopefully soon zinakuja.
Mm-hmm.
Be it
but
again.
You're just in your early 20s anyway.
Yeah.
All right. So did they support that dream of yours?
They did, but actually cash was the issue.
Mm-hmm.
And you know, our family tuko wengi,
mm-hmm.
we are a football team.
Mm-hmm.
Plus sub, mimi
plus
last born.
When you're substitute.
Substitute.
All right.
Yeah.
So, pesa ziko na kazi. Pesa ilikuwa na kazi.
Zilikuwa na kazi na pia mimi sikutaka kupea mzazi pressure.
Mm-hmm.
I'm a grown up, I'm mm-hmm. above 18. Mm-hmm. So I had to hustle my way
mm-hmm.
my way out.
All right. You yeah. got to Nairobi. And what was that thing that you said? If I get to Nairobi and I get a chance to do this thing, I'm going to make a way out for myself and even my mom and dad.
So before I came to Nairobi,
mm-hmm.
I actually had a small notebook I wrote down because mm-hmm. later Nairobi.
Mm-hmm.
I first put women's candle.
Mm-hmm.
Nikeka tu hasoli yanga photography.
Mm-hmm.
And I also say that
so
I must.
So kwa list ukaeka number one, wanawake.
X.
Alamu kukendele na list.
Nikendele na list fresh.
I hope you figure that you only have women in studio from the camera to the guys in the background. And they might not take this lightly. Why did you have to say women to the side first?
I've been through a lot in mm-hmm. relationships.
Uh-huh. All right.
Yeah.
And we are not going to talk about that.
Yeah, that's
so
that personal.
You feel like it was going to slow you down?
It was going to kind of take away my energy.
All right.
Ahead.
Right. Yeah. So number two kwa list ilikuwa nini?
Number two ilikuwa photography.
Mm-hmm.
Ndo inipatie pesa.
Mm-hmm.
Then I get to school.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
All right. So you had your camera. You had bought your second camera by
then. I hadn't. It's sikuwa na camera at that uh-huh. moment. So I happened to be on social media then. I saw there's a guy.
Mm-hmm.
Kutoka majuu, alikuwa anauza camera.
Mm-hmm.
It was a Canon 700D.
Mm-hmm.
So he was selling it at around 50K.
Mm-hmm.
So I inboxed him. And with my little saving that I made,
mm-hmm.
I wanted now to get a camera, then I come to Nairobi.
Mm-hmm.
So I inboxed him on Facebook, we talked.
Mm-hmm.
Then he told me, yeah, come over Nairobi, I'm at Yaya Center.
Mm-hmm.
We can meet over there, then I sell for you the camera.
Camera.
Mm-hmm. And at that
Where
time,
did you see this guy first? On which platform?
On Facebook. I'm
on Facebook?
Fan, yeah, of social media.
You're a fan of social media.
So much.
It
so,
goes hand in hand with photography anyway. Heavy. One side.
Kitu moja.
All right.
Yeah.
So Facebook is very important for a photographer. We note that.
Yeah.
You met this guy, got your camera. Were you scared of being frauded? Because...
Actually, when I came to Nairobi, I stayed with my sister.
Mm-hmm.
She was living in Kayole at that time.
Mm-hmm.
So when
1960.
I went for, 1960 kwenye hapo.
Mm-hmm.
So I told him, Caesar, kuna mtu ananiuzia camera, mm-hmm. but at a very cheap price.
Mm-hmm.
Caesar kuelewana na mimi kabisa. Mm-hmm. Kaniambia wewe unajua Nairobi iko na wakora wewe ndio umetoka village juzi akinako keti na chuo yako so tukaletana but me I just said I must get it so I left na imani yangu simjui yani jui I went to his center we met at his place na imani yangu tu so he accepted to sell for me the camera at that time I had around 16,000 yeah
But the camera from was going savings. For 50,000.
Yeah, it was going for 50,000.
Mm-hmm.
So I tried to explain myself, you know, mlio ambako jitete, kaambia mzee, nipunguzie bei, I can't afford at the moment. So he told me, you have 16K and the selling price is 50K.
Mm-hmm.
So how will it work out? Then I took a letter and a letter and then he told me, he'll sell for me the camera at 40.
Mm-hmm.
So I told him, the best we can do, Maybe I give you this 16, then I look for the rest of 4,000.
Uh-huh.
Then I give you 20, then I'll be paying in monthly installments.
Uh-huh.
So God brought for me the platform already.
Uh-huh.
Akakubali at Juani.
Uh-huh.
Akakubali kunizia yo camera at 20.
Uh-huh.
So he told me, go hustle your way out. Dupate your 20.
Is this the camera you're talking about?
Yeah, this is the camera.
And this is the camera you bought when you got to Nairobi.
Yeah, until nikajipigia branding.
Uh-huh. No, na Andrew Were
photography.
Photography yeah. with a camera right there.
Yeah.
You had ulikuwa understand the power of branding and the power of good equipment back then.
I didn't understand. Understood about it, but being raised in a big family is what has given me a lot of advantages.
Mm-hmm.
I get to learn a lot from my brothers, my elder brothers, me and your last born, so I learn from their mistakes.
Uh-huh.
So hizo ndo zina ni guide. My brothers angu pia advice zao. It helped me a lot.
So it helps you a lot to be part of your family.
And also
you're very grateful to be part of that family.
I'm grateful.
All right, I like this. Yes. When was this again?
Here it was a charity work.
Uh-huh.
We had gone with a group called the Aboki Foundation.
Uh-huh.
That's when I got passion into helping kids and mentoring kids.
Uh-huh.
This is Aboki Foundation.
Uh-huh. So you went to see kids here?
Yeah, Kawa West. This was the crew.
This was the crew. How did you meet this crew? This group of beautiful
only,
women. Because you're the only man in this picture.
Mtu wa watu.
Oh, mtu wa watu.
Yeah, I'm so influential.
You're so influential and people just like the energy
people
around you.
People like me, like everywhere. Henry, hi. Hug.
You're blowing your trumpet and I like this.
Yes.
But I thought ulisema wanawake kando. Anyway, that's a story for another day. So here you went to give back to the kids. Which led to your next project now, in which you're teaching kids French, kids in children's home.
That came in.
Uh-huh.
I've been through a lot. When I came in to Nairobi, started photography.
Mm-hmm.
First of all, tulileta na June Caesar.
Mm-hmm.
He told me, you don't want to help me some work. I was helping her in a shop.
Uh-huh.
Then she told me, you have to. Inafaa tu rudi home. But me, singeza rudi home and I have a camera. Nienda home tena ni hassle. Nianze kuchoma makaa.
Uh-huh.
I said, no.
Uh-huh.
There is something.
There's something for you
so I had to leave.
She didn't understand the vision,
but
now she gets it at least.
Yeah, at least now she can understand.
All right.
Yeah.
So sometimes people will not get your vision.
They won't get your vision.
Watakwambia kaa kwa duka.
Kaa kwa duka.
Because it brings money every day.
Yeah.
At least ni hustle one as a shika. It's something tangible.
Yeah.
But sometimes you just need to stick to your vision.
Yeah.
Which is a beautiful thing.
Yeah.
Powerful Henry Were. Y254 channel on Twitter, Y254_channel on Instagram, and Y254 on Facebook is the way to interact with us. Hashtag is Y in the morning. Hashtag is Entrepreneurship Tuesday. You can direct your questions to Henry Were. And if you're watching us from Kakamega County today, you're represented on Y in the morning. So please chat, talk to us. Your views, your comments, and your questions are invited. So, Mr. Henry,
yes.
I'm really interested in this project that you're doing with the kids, in which you're teaching them French.
Yes,
tell me how this works.
Actually this came through life nimepitia Nairobi, mm-hmm. sijakuwa na place ya kuishi.
Mm-hmm.
I've been surviving in one of the campuses I can't
mention.
I've been sleeping on the Wi-Fi villas,
mm-hmm.
for quite a long time, mm-hmm. in 2017 yote.
Mm-hmm.
Nimekuwa nikilala nje.
Mm-hmm.
Used normally asubuhi naamka,
mm-hmm.
napiga picha photoshoot kwa campus,
mm-hmm.
then jioni ikifika najisunda pale kwa villa kwa baridi,
mm-hmm.
asubuhi ikifika shughuli ni vile vile tu.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
But is it what you're still doing right now?
No, uh-huh. I thank God by now I can afford my own house,
uh-huh.
at Ngong Road.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, bedsitter.
Uh-huh. Bedsitter. Everybody starts there.
Yeah.
Every successful person who started from the bottom,
yes.
has to start from a bedsitter somewhere.
Yes.
And don't forget to take the images of that apartment,
exactly.
So that when you when you get to your big place, you're going to do it.
I love documenting my story because
uh-huh.
I want to be a motivational speaker in future.
Uh-huh.
Just talk about my story, write a book.
Uh-huh.
Get to inspire more people.
All right.
Wasikufemoyo.
So currently, which children's home are you working with?
I'm working with a shelter children's home, mm-hmm. in Kibiko Ngong.
Mm-hmm.
I opened up a project called the French for Kids.
Mm-hmm.
Basically, I teach kids French.
Mm-hmm.
Just mentor them,
mm-hmm.
take them through, because I want to open a larger opportunities for them,
uh-huh.
to study abroad,
uh-huh.
and in Francophonie,
uh-huh.
by the French-speaking countries.
All right.
Yeah, that will be a very huge advantage for them.
All right. So you think learning different languages,
yes.
Is advantageous to a kid?
Very much
opens
advantageous.
More opportunities and doors,
yes.
to these kids.
Yes.
All right. So you're focusing on French, or you speak English as well?
English,
you
yes.
speak Luya
and Luya
and Luya
and some Spanish
and some Spanish.
Yeah.
How did you get to learn Spanish?
Spanish online. I'm self-taught.
Oh, you're self-taught?
Yeah.
Right, so when you're not taking pictures, you're online trying to learn
online,
something?
Ever.
Always trying to learn something?
Yeah.
All right. What do you attribute to this? Always being online, learning things. How has it helped you?
Personally, it has helped me to grow,
uh-huh.
mentally. Bearing in mind I haven't been to campus,
mm-hmm.
so it builds my brain,
mm-hmm.
daily. I get to learn more new things,
mm-hmm.
I learn from people's problem,
mm-hmm.
like Akothe,
mm-hmm.
like she inspires me a lot,
mm-hmm.
I love her story, like ametoka far na as long as people are
against it's so her. Nice
yeah
it's so but good I that you brought up Akothe because she's a trending topic,
yeah,
and she's inspiring you. She's come from the bottom, now she's at the top, and
yeah.
people are attacking her,
yeah, you know, mm-hmm. most people are attacking her because
mm-hmm.
maybe they think she's seeming different from them. You can't attack someone because she's seeming different from you,
uh-huh.
but as much as they think maybe she's over too much on social media,
uh-huh.
but she's doing her thing,
uh-huh. So
if
you
it
advise
makes her happy,
mm-hmm.
it's okay.
Mm-hmm. As long as
yeah.
as long as she's happy,
yeah.
it's the best thing.
Yes.
To sijifanye sisi ndio tuko morally upright than
yeah.
anybody else.
Yeah, exactly.
All right. So what would you tell parents who tell their kids, you're always on social media, you're always on social media, unafanya nini kwa social media, do something. What would you tell parents like this?
Actually, it depends with how you raised up your kid.
Because
for me, we were raised up in a different way. We
uh-huh.
were taught A for attitude,
uh-huh.
B for behavior,
uh-huh.
C for character,
uh-huh.
and D for self-dependence.
Uh-huh.
And that's how I was brought.
Uh-huh.
So when I get to social media, no.
Powerful words right there.
Yeah.
You can bring me up to speed again. A for attitude.
B
for behavior.
B for behavior.
C for character. And D for dependence.
Self-dependence.
Self-dependence.
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah.
Wonderful. So that's how you were raised. So when anything you do, you always remember the four.
I remember
attributes.
The four.
Your attitude is very important.
Very much important.
Your behavior is very important.
It determines the kind of people you meet.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
And the people you'll have around you.
Yeah, you'll hang around with.
All right.
Yeah.
What is the next one? Character.
Character.
And
dependence.
Dependence.
Yeah.
I'm interested in attitude. What is this attitude all about? Your attitude towards what?
How you react to issues.
Uh-huh.
Like something has pissed you off, then you're like, you overreact.
Uh-huh.
You know your reactions.
Uh-huh.
You shouldn't allow your reactions to control you.
Uh-huh.
You should be short-tempered guy.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Right, so you just, you interact with something, think about it,
yeah.
think it through first,
yeah,
before you
it.
Act.
Before you act.
Towards it.
Yeah.
Powerful man.
Yeah.
I like this. What people don't know about you is that you're also a comedian.
Yes, I'm a comedian.
Uh-huh.
I love seeing people happy.
Uh-huh.
That's it. seeing someone smile, that's my joy.
All right.
That's why I do more of travel photography. Mm-hmm. Don't know if there's a slideshow for that.
Mm-hmm. All right, maybe you can project the pictures.
Yeah,
that's why
picture
you do
stories. Humanitarian photography.
Humanitarian photography.
Yeah, it
so you like
stories.
To put smiles on people's faces.
Smiles.
Even when you're just holding a camera to their face and tell them smile, even when they're not happy.
Joke. Yeah. All right. I must joke around. Uh-huh. My clients, I engage them.
Oh, so jokes. The comedy helps during photography sessions.
Yeah,
you crack
package.
Jokes. Instead of telling people smile, you crack a joke and
they smile. They smile and capture that moment.
All right.
Yeah.
Wonderful. That's a wonderful approach to whatever you do. So what next for you as a brand?
As a brand, I had to rebrand myself as Henry Films from Henry Ware Photography. Because I started doing photography, then got to videography, courtesy of Matolab Films.
Mm-hmm. Shout out to Matolab Films.
Mm-hmm. And Dashi Photography. Mm-hmm. Thanks, I and Ottoman's idea. They're the only friends I have so far. I had to reduce my surrounding
your circle.
To grow my circle. Mm-hmm. And they're both 30, 40.
Uh-huh.
So, mtu wa age yangu, like, we can't communicate the same because of the life nimekuwa through. Like someone at 20, at my age now, I tried to pick for them ideas. I told them when I started the French project, I wrote on my social media account, I said, anyone doing French, kindly come in. I'm setting up a project at Shelter Children's Home. We mentor kids. No one ever responded to that. But the moment I had an achievement to meet the ambassador of France at the embassy some 2 weeks ago. Then I posted that on my social media. People like, hey, I'm proud of you, bro. Bro, you're doing good. Like, people always want to celebrate you, but no one will always support you from your humble beginnings.
All right.
Yeah.
So people want to celebrate the achievements.
Yeah, the achievements.
They don't want to be part of the journey.
They don't want to
people
be
like
part.
Shortcuts, in short.
Yeah.
All right.
So that's why I had to put off some people and just be live as a loner and I do my thing.
All right.
Yeah.
So you prefer to surround yourself with people who are older than you?
Older people. I just get a lot of content.
You get a lot of content.
Ideas.
Ideas.
Yeah.
And mentorship.
Mentorship,
as well.
Exactly.
So you'd advise people to have at least people with experience around them.
Yeah.
At least two people with experience around them.
Yeah. I came up with that idea. 2019, I said, this is 2019, it's my year. I must be successful. I must go to France this year. I'm praying for that. I must have my own company as much as I'm working under Queen Studios right now. But I must push myself. So these I made these resolutions when my friends, when nilikuwa naishi nao. So after kutoka kwa campus, kusurvive kwa campus, best yangu alikubali kuniita. So I went to stay at his place. But sijui mbona aliniita, but all that time he has been planning kunifukuza. So I came to know this letter in February. So he was just pitching how venyatantuanyisha kwake jake. So I came to know that it was painful. Alinifukuza and he was like a brother to me. Tumesoma naye high school all that long. Then akanitoanisha hivyo. So kamwa tu like my best day, I don't trust anyone. The only thing I trust in is my M-Pesa. Kama una pesa una kai iko iko ezi kudanganya.
All right. I like this. The only thing you trust now is
my M-Pesa.
Humans are going to let you down.
Yeah, humans will let you down always. That, like this guy, nilikuwa nimemtrust sana. Na mimi mess up sana, but it's okay. It's a long
story. But it's okay.
Yeah.
Out of all these things you've been through, from going from coach surfing, like sleeping outside, not having a home to go to, all these things you've learned over time.
It's over time. It's a process.
Yes.
You must make mistakes.
How have they built you to this person you are today?
Actually, I'm proud. Because mostly when I talk, like people are like, is that really you talking? Like I chat mostly with, I have very many Facebook friends. I chat to them, they are like, I expected when we meet, they say, I expected you to be like around 27. Expected you to be 28 years. Like, imenijenga akili sana, imenifungua brain.
All these
experiences.
They've opened your mind so much.
Sana.
So the process is always very important.
Just trust the process.
And you're still in the process.
Yeah.
I appreciate
consistency
you.
And positive daily habits, yeah.
Your social media platforms, your camera is number four. From the comedy one to the photography one to this project that you have with kids.
Yes.
And please invite people to come assist you in this project that you have with kids because it's an amazing project.
Okay. My social media platforms are Henry Were Photography, mm-hmm. Sir Henry Films, mm-hmm. all over Facebook or Instagram, mm-hmm. and Twitter. Mm-hmm. Comedy it's at Ujinga Zawere, mm-hmm. that's where I do comedy, mm-hmm. but not verbal comedy. Mm-hmm. Mostly I deal with non-verbal. Mm-hmm. Ndo pia ni cover up wale wase hawezi sikia.
So you're always considering people. Yeah, from the kids,
yeah, from the
to
kids,
those who are able differently.
The neglected part of the society. At Ujinga Zawere, and my Facebook account is Were Joe Henry. Mm-hmm. I love my name.
You love your name.
Sana.
And it's going to be a brand. And it's going to be the name of your company when you make it big.
When I make it, Sir Henry Films.
Sir Henry Films.
And the French project, it's French for Kids. Mm-hmm. I'm under Great Toto, uh-huh. the one which manages that children's home, Great uh-huh. Toto Mentorship. Mm-hmm. We teach kids apart from French, mm-hmm. modeling, uh-huh. singing, dancing.
Uh-huh. Other aspects of life in which they can use to make money as well. Thank you very much, Mr. Henry, for coming through to Why in the Morning.
Yes.
We appreciate you.
Yes.
But kama mtu wa Kakamega, najua kuna salamu za kutuma. So, tuma salamu, alafu tumalize.
Yeah, I would like to send my greetings to my mom.
Haujanza vizuri. Ningependa kutuma
sana. Ningependa kutuma kwa salamu zangu kwa mama msasi. Akiwa ananiangalia pale nyumbani. Also my dad. My principal, Mr. Godfrey Owori. Mr. Namunga. My mentor, my dad, Aspanao. It's like a dad, Dashi Photography, Dashi Freddy, he's a model. And I'd like also to send a shout out to Queen Studios Photography and Videography, the company that I work under. Hao ndio wamenijenga sana. And also Mato Lab Films. Yeah.
All right. Wonderful. Thank you very much, Mr. Henry.
Yes.
We appreciate you. Keep doing what you're doing.
Yes.
And keep building yourself and building the society at large.
Yeah, that's exactly what I want to do.
Wonderful.
Continue the courage.
Yes, this has been another segment on Entrepreneurship Tuesday on Why in the Morning. I go by the name of Barry Moses, or It's Barry Moore on every social media platform. Joy Mushache is coming up next with another powerful interview. You don't want to miss this. Don't go nowhere. Don't touch that down.